Good afternoon. Our government has aggressively pursued policy decisions in the wireless sector with a very clear goal in mind: more choice, lower prices, and better services for Canadian consumers in every region of Canada. Recently, we made important decisions to put consumers first in Canada's wireless sector. We liberalized foreign investment rules in our telecom sector. We introduced new rules that require wireless companies to share cell towers whenever they can so that fewer towers are needed in our communities. We also believe that communities need to have more say in how new cell tower locations are chosen. We are tackling wholesale wireless roaming rates as well to promote greater competition across Canada. And we are empowering the CRTC and Industry Canada to impose penalties on wireless carriers that don't play by the rules. And in 2015, we will hold the 2500 megahertz spectrum auction with rules specifically designed to benefit consumers, particularly those Canadians who live in rural parts of our country. And today, I'm pleased to announce the results of the 700 megahertz spectrum auction. On the 14th of January, Canada's 700 megahertz spectrum auction began. 700 megahertz spectrum is the highest quality wireless frequency ever auctioned in Canada. This spectrum travels longer distances, requires fewer cell towers, and penetrates through building walls, elevators, and even through underground parking lots. 10 Canadian companies competed over the last 5 weeks in this auction, and the auction had 108 rounds of bidding. In total, 97 licenses have been awarded to 8 companies across Canada. This wireless spectrum auction is a clear win for Canadians. First and foremost, 8 wireless carriers, including at least 4 wireless players in every region of the country, now hold this high-quality spectrum. Each of Canada's 3 largest national wireless companies were able to obtain a significant amount of the 700 megahertz spectrum to deploy the latest technologies to their existing customers across Canada. And key regional players like SaskTel, MTS, Videotron, Eastlink have all secured spectrum to maintain and expand their regional footprints. And this auction also yielded a valuable return for Canadian taxpayers. Just as a reminder, the AWS spectrum auction that took place in 2008 raised roughly $4.3 billion. The total revenue that was generated from this auction is $5.27 billion, the highest return ever for a wireless auction in Canada. This revenue will go directly to the Consolidated Revenue Fund within the next 30 business days. And here are the results broken down by province. In Newfoundland and Labrador, Bell, Eastlink, Rogers, and TELUS won licenses. In Nova Scotia, Bell, Eastlink, Rogers, and TELUS won licenses. In Prince Edward Island, Bell, Eastlink, Rogers, and TELUS won licenses. And in New Brunswick, Bell, Eastlink, Rogers, and TELUS won licenses. In Quebec, Videotron, TELUS, Rogers, and Bell won licenses. In Ontario, 4 wireless providers will receive 700 megahertz spectrum. Videotron, Bell, Rogers, and TELUS won licenses in Northern Ontario, while Eastlink, Bell, Rogers, and TELUS won licenses in the South. In the Yukon, the Northwest Territories, and Nunavut, Bell, Phoenix, and TELUS will join existing players with 700 megahertz spectrum licenses. And in Manitoba, Bell, MTS, Rogers, and TELUS won licenses. In Saskatchewan, Bell, SaskTel, TELUS, and Rogers won licenses. And in Alberta, there are 4 wireless providers who will receive 700 megahertz spectrum licenses: Videotron, Rogers, Bell, and TELUS. And in my home province of British Columbia, 4 wireless providers will receive 700 megahertz spectrum licenses: Bell, TELUS, Videotron, and Rogers. So in summary, the outcome of the auction supports more choice for Canadians by enabling a 4th wireless player in every region of Canada. Incumbent wireless companies have secured spectrum to deliver the next generation of wireless devices to their customers. And the auction revenue of $5.27 billion, which is the most ever for a wireless auction in Canada, will be reinvested into priorities that matter to Canadians. Companies that obtain the spectrum will be able to start using these high-quality frequencies to serve their customers by mid-April. And the success of this auction is certainly not a coincidence. The auction was a success because the rules were designed to put consumers front and center. In the summer of 2013, there was a great debate across this country regarding our government's wireless policy. Much of this debate has been filled with assumptions and speculation, some misinformation also about the government's policies and the outcome of today's auction. But while this debate has played out amongst analysts and commentators, our government has one clear goal that we focused on, which was to take concrete steps to create more choice with lower prices and better wireless services for Canadians all across this country. And with today's results, it's clear that we made the right decisions. And because of this, Canadians are the big winners of this spectrum auction.